Good evening, I'm Paul Fraser, and this is the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa issued Royal Order 24 today for this year, forming a committee to revise the draft of the family law and examine its provisions to ensure it matches Islamic Sharia. The committee is formed from the Supreme Council for Islamic Affairs and Judges and includes Sheikh Abdul Hussein bin Khalaf Al Asfur, Sheikh Dr. Abdul Latif bin Mahmoud Al Mahmoud, Sheikh Adnan bin Abdullah Al Khatan, Sheikh Nasser bin Ahmed Al Asfur, Sheikh Rashid bin Hassan Al Buwainin, Sheikh Dr. Rashid bin Muhammad Al Hajeri, Sheikh Dr. Suleiman bin Mansur Al Setri, Sheikh Jawad Abdullah Abbas Hussein, Sheikh Dr. Abdul Rahman bin Dahrar Al Sher, and Sheikh Muhammad Taher bin Suleiman Al Madani. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa affirmed that the national march in the Kingdom of Bahrain has always been based on justice from Islamic principles. The Royal Order is based on Islamic ideals which unite and do not differentiate between the people of Bahrain. His Majesty noted on the occasion of the issuance of family law and forming a committee to review its provisions that these are important steps to ensure the extent of its conformity with the provisions of Islamic law, which affirms and reinforces Bahrain's commitment to Islamic principles and values without any external affiliations far from Islamic ideals, customs and traditions. His Majesty said that external powers that have tried to disunify national unity have faced the national will, which in turn has rejected all factors of disagreement through sectarian division. His Majesty expressed the need to maintain the national spirit and take into account the privacy of the people of Bahrain. His Majesty stressed that the importance of protecting Bahrain and its citizens during difficult times and affirmed the stability of the national spirit that brings everyone together and serves the interests of all. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, received at Gudabiya Palace today the Minister of Works, Municipalities Affairs and Urban Planning, Essam bin Abdullah Khalaf, who briefed His Royal Highness on a number of main road development projects, including Al Fata Road. His Royal Highness stressed the necessity of improving roads according to the highest standards that guarantee a smooth traffic flow and take into account future residential and investment requirements. His Royal Highness affirmed the keenness of the government to develop infrastructure in various areas of the kingdom to provide comfort to citizens and residents and serve the efforts of the comprehensive development that the kingdom witnesses in various fields. His Royal Highness highlighted the efforts of the Ministry of Works, Municipalities Affairs and Urban Planning in maintaining and developing various facilities related to the road sector and ordered the acceleration of work in order to complete existing projects as soon as possible. The Minister of Works briefed His Royal Highness on the procedures the Ministry has taken to develop Al Fata Road and the procedures that will be taken after the completion of the preliminary procedures. The Minister of Works also expressed thanks and gratitude to His Royal Highness for his continuous support to the Ministry to develop the infrastructure and facilitate the procedures of implementing its projects. He stated that upon the directives of His Royal Highness, the detailed design works and tender documents have been completed and qualifying contractors for the project will begin soon. We'll be right back. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, chaired the weekly cabinet meeting at Gudibiya Palace today. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister welcomed the official visit of the Prime Minister of Thailand, Prayut Chan-o-cha, and the accompanying delegation who will be arriving in the kingdom today, praising the depth of Bahraini-Malaysian relations and affirming that this visit will contribute to enhancing the prospects of bilateral coordination between the two countries, politically, economically, and in the field of investment. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister thanked the Arab League and its Secretary General for the grand celebration which was held to honour His Royal Highness and grant him the Shield of Development Work, which Sheikh Ali bin Khalifa Al Khalifa received on his behalf. He also expressed pride in the speeches of participants delivered on the occasion. The Cabinet congratulated His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, affirming that it is a great honour for the government of Bahrain, led by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister. On the occasion of International Workers' Day, His Royal Highness praised the effective role of Bahraini workers in building the country, affirming the government's keenness to reinforce labour gains and improve the working environment. He also commended the role of trade unions in developing labour achievements. His Royal Highness went on to commend the role of civil society establishments in supporting the government's efforts to develop the youth sector and provide them with training and educational opportunities. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister thanked Al Mabara Al Khalifia Foundation for holding the first forum under the patronisation of Deputy Prime Minister Sheikh Khalid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, praising the role of the foundation, chaired by President of Al Mabara Al Khalifia Board of Trustees Sheikh Zain bin Khalid Al Khalifa, for holding events that provide young people with the opportunity to extend their knowledge. He highlighted the importance of reviving ancient places of heritage and history to support investment and culture, noting the opening of Al Khalifia Library, which was patronised by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, who deputised Sheikh Khalifa bin Ali bin Khalifa Al Khalifa to inaugurate. His Royal Highness directed all ministries and government bodies subject to civil service law to abide by the decisions of the Cabinet relating to the standards of scholarship and the organisational decisions of the Cabinet, which is responsible to the relations between government establishments, embassies and foreign scholarships. He affirmed the importance of the country's employees not accepting training scholarships provided by third parties without obtaining prior approval from the specialised authorities in the government. His Royal Highness reaffirmed abiding by the Cabinet's decision of instructing the Ministry of Foreign Affairs to be the only body to competently receive offers of scholarships, civil training courses and field visits to civilians provided by embassies and foreign missions to employees subject to civil service law, civil society establishments, employees or individuals. The Cabinet expressed condolences to the custodian of the two holy mosques, King Salman bin Abdulaziz Al Saud, and the Saudi people for the victims of the helicopter crash of the Saudi military participating in the Arab coalition forces whilst performing their national duty, praying to God Almighty to rest their souls in peace. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister also congratulated His Highness the Emir of Qatar, Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani, and the people of Qatar for the release of Qatari citizens who were held in Iraq and their safe return, wishing Qatar safety, security and development. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister directed to continue developing the quality of health services and training medical personnel by reinforcement from high professional experience and the latest equipment. The Cabinet reviewed the main important economic indicators recorded in its fourth chapter of 2016. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister urged to continue motivating Bahraini citizens to establish small and medium enterprises and support and encourage providing quality opportunities for Bahrainis with added value in the private sector and to undertake additional efforts to ensure that employment of citizens is not affected by current economic challenges. A memorandum of understanding between the Supreme Council of Islamic Affairs in Bahrain and the Russian Council of Muftis was approved and the concerned ministry was authorised to sign the agreement. The Cabinet approved a draft law to ratify an extradition treaty between the Kingdom of Bahrain and Russia and referred it to the legislative authority to complete the rest of the constitutional procedures. A draft decree to approve protocol to amend Article 50A and 56 of the Convention on International Civil Aviation signed in Montreal in 2016 was also approved. Finally, the Cabinet referred to the Ministerial Committee for Legal Affairs a memorandum from the Foreign Minister of Foreign Affairs on the request to establish the Bahrain Green Building Council as a branch of the World Council of Green Buildings. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, received at Gudabiya Palace today the winners of the Kuwait International Quran Competition, Mahana Al Buwainin and Mohammed Samir, who respectively won first and second place in the competition. His Royal Highness praised the achievements of Bahrainis in which they enhanced the status of the kingdom at regional and international levels, which reflects that Bahrain is capable of making accomplishments in all fields. He added that the kingdom is keen on supporting Quran centres, expressing pride in the honourable achievement made by the two winners, wishing them further success and further accomplishment to be a source of all motivation for all Bahrainis. He went on to stress the importance of abiding by the values and principles of the Holy Quran. Al Buwainin and Samir expressed thanks and appreciation for His Royal Highness's continuous support, which has contributed in reaching a number of achievements for the kingdom and its people. The first Deputy Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, Honorary President of Bahrain Mixed Martial Arts Federation, that's the BMMAF, and founder of Khalid bin Hamad Mixed Martial Arts, the KHKMMA organization. His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa confirmed that Kazakhstan will host the 6th edition of Brave Championship next Saturday, which will be organized by KHKMMA. His Highness stated that selecting Kazakhstan to host the championship is due to its geographical location, being the entrance to Asia and Europe, which will facilitate the expansion of the event, adding that he had given his directives to the foundation to complete all the required arrangements for the championship. He noted that efforts will continue according to the strategy aimed at expanding the organization and holding of the event in various world capitals and cities, which will enhance its international presence and will contribute to its success. His Highness expressed thanks and appreciation to India for hosting the 5th edition that achieved an outstanding success, hailing the role of All India Mixed Martial Arts Association in contributing to and participating in the preparation for the championship. He expressed aspiration to enhance cooperation with the association to achieve further success for the sport. His Highness commended the audience's interaction, praising the fighters' high level of performance in the competitions and congratulating the winners, wishing the other fighters luck in upcoming editions. A white weapon show was presented to His Highness Sheikh Khalid, which is considered part of Indian traditional military shows.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to be brave. Mumbai, India, I have one question for you and one question only. Are you ready?
India, the home of Spice, Bollywood, and now Brave. His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, First Deputy President of Supreme Council for Youth and Sports Affairs, Honorary President of Bahrain Martial Arts Federation, the BMMAF, and founder of Khalid bin Hamad Mixed Martial Arts, KHK MMA, yesterday hailed the success of the 5th edition of Brave Fighting Championship in Mumbai, India. Brave Combat Federation's 5th installment in Mumbai was deemed a success, with Carl Booth and Gurashan Manag both coming out with close wins in the two main events over two tough competitors, Tahir Hadbi and Abdul Munir. 20 fighters from 11 countries around the world took part in the event organized by Brave Combat Federation, which is part of KHK MMA in cooperation with the All Indian Mixed Martial Arts Association.
I'm really enjoyed the show anyway. It was good to put on a performance, even though people are saying it's the bloodiest one. Good. People enjoyed it. Said it was going to be a bloodbath earlier on. I think I won it. I just wanted more out of it, to be fair. I wanted to land some heavy head kicks.
On the occasion, Sheikh Khalid praised the attention given to the sports sector, especially mixed martial arts, by His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, and also to the fans attending the event in India.
I would like to tell His Highness that, thank you very much for organizing this. It's great entertainment for all of us. And I think this is going to turn out to be something very, very big. I think what he has started is something fabulous. It's just going to go on to be much bigger.
It's fantastic what Brave is doing to the sport in India. It's fabulous. You're seeing those Indian fighters getting motivated, and which hadn't been happening in India before. And you can see the energy crowd is bringing in. And this kind of events should happen more what Brave has done. I'm pretty excited about it.
I think it's been awesome so far. I think it's great to see a lot of the Indian fighters here today. I think the sport is catching up in India. It's good to see young boys getting a chance to fight against international fighters. And it's also good to see our city put up such a good show and do such a good job at hosting. So I'm enjoying it.
It's amazing. It's a very different concept. It's the first time in India, and I think I love it because I love sports, and because of my family background, I'm a wrestler, so I just love this concept. Yeah.
For the first time, I'm enjoying this atmosphere because I've always seen on TV, and when you're far away, you don't experience that much how much I'm experiencing right now, and it's my goosebumps are coming. I'm like, oh my God, they're bleeding. It's amazing. Actually, what I can say, that is called brave, that real brave people, and they're fighting for their own country. And they're so amazing. I mean, it's always good to see them, fighting, and it's for real.
The Mumbai event was the 5th overall and 3rd at an international venue following championship in Brazil and Abu Dhabi. Brave's next destination will be held on the 29th of April in Kazakhstan. Reporting for Bahrain Television, this is Mohammed Janahi.
A consultative meeting was held today between the Supreme Council for Women and Legislative Authority to identify the important framework of follow-up towards the implementation of the strategic plan for the advancement of Bahraini women. More on this story now with Heba Adolghafur.
Following the strategy of the Supreme Council for Women to empower Bahraini women and merge their needs in the development programs to protect their rights, provide them with diverse opportunities and ensure their stability as active partners in order to enhance their quality of life. A consultative meeting was held today in response to what was agreed upon in the meeting between Her Royal Highness, wife of His Majesty the King, and President of the Supreme Council for Women, Princess Sabiqa bint Ibrahim Al Khalifa, with the Legislative Authority in 2015.
The main priorities that Bahraini women would require for the coming period. So, for example, we have discussed the necessary amendments that should be taken into consideration by the Legislative Council when it comes to, for example, the nationality law, or when it comes to the family law, or when it comes to the situation of women in the workforce. We have also discussed the latest or the progress so far when it comes to mainstreaming women need in the government program.
Distinguished cooperation between the legislation authority and the council was clearly shown in the meeting, supporting and monitoring the implementation of the National Plan for the Advancement of Bahraini Women through the enactment of the necessary legislation to protect their rights in various fields.
Implementation of the National Plan of Advancement of the Bahraini Women at the Government Action Plan for the years 2014-2018. I do believe that such meetings of coordination, and I think this initiative is important, for us at the National Council, for both chambers, to understand from the Supreme Council of Women what should be achieved, what did we achieve to start with, and what should be achieved within the coming year.
Many laws have been discussed to comply with the international conventions and treaties, promote the achievement of equality between women and men, and support their development in various fields of political, economic, and social development.
We are here actually to understand exactly how we can empower the woman through the legislations and through actually the development and empowerment of first of all, changing the legislations, and if there are any of the legislations or if there are any of the laws, actually it's not supporting the woman empowerment. We are there in order to focus on those laws and in order to develop those laws.
With pride, Bahrain's accomplishments in nurturing and promoting Bahraini women and their prosperity were displayed, making Bahrain the first Arab women's capital.
Since women are the real architects of any society, our wise authorities give them special attention. The Supreme Council for Women, along with the Shura Council and the Council of Representatives, discuss today how to empower Bahraini women through adequate laws and legislations. Reporting for Bahrain International, Imhaba Abdelghafour.
The Kingdom hosted the International Conference on Education today under the theme Teachers' Role in the Quality of Education, organised by the Gulf Arab States Educational Research Centre in cooperation with the Ministry of Education and the Arab Fund and Economic and Social Development. A number of academic experts and researchers from UNESCO and world countries participated in the conference. The Minister of Education affirmed that the Kingdom achieved honourable results in facing educational loss that violates the right of students to appropriate education. The Director General of the Arab Bureau of Education for Gulf States, Dr. Ali bin Abdul Khalik Al-Khani, noted that organising the conference coordinates with the Bureau's efforts of developing the level of education and its outcomes in member states and focuses on improving the qualification of teachers. The director of the Gulf Arab States Educational Research Centre, Suleiman Al-Askari, stated that the conference not only discusses finding temporary partial solutions, but also discusses other broader horizons of waste in education. The director of the International Bureau of Education, Memnat Setsa Maropi, expressed pride in her participation in the conference, stressing the importance of qualifying teachers in light of accelerating technological developments. The Minister of Information Affairs and Chairman of the Board of Trustees of Bahrain Institute for Political Development, the BIPD, Ali bin Mohammed Al-Romehi, participated in the 14th Arab Media Forum in the state of Kuwait, held under the patronage and presence of Kuwait's Prime Minister, Sheikh Jaber al-Mubarak al-Hamad al-Sabah, during which the Kingdom of Bahrain has been named the guest of honour for the forum's current session themed Media Life, hosted by the state of Kuwait, with the participation of Gulf and Arab information ministers, officials, journalists, intellectuals and academics. The minister has urged the Gulf and Arab media to bear its historic responsibility in boosting the cohesion of the internal front in the Gulf Cooperation Council countries and in maintaining the Arab nation's cultural and civilizational identity in view of the current risks and challenges, considering the media as the constructive but non-destructive tool of development. In his speech, Al-Romehi expressed his appreciation and pride in the depth of the ever-growing close historic fraternal Bahraini-Kuwaiti bonds fostered by His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al-Khalifa and the Kuwaiti Emir of Humanity, His Highness Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmed Al-Jaber Al-Sabah. The minister praised Kuwaiti generosity and its success stories, quoting the poet who labelled it as the giggle of destinies for humankind. He cited Kuwait's leading role in the fields of media, sports, arts and culture, and the professional role of its media in boosting the spirit of national unity across all audiovisual and written media. The minister said that the Arabian Gulf is entrusted on the shoulders of all of us, urging journalists and media professionals to bear the responsibility in preserving the internal front and the development and civilizational accomplishments. He stressed the significance of the development of traditional radio and television channels, as well as the press and publications, and transforming the media into a huge global industry that grows at 5% per annum amid the anticipated rise in global media expenditure from $1.6 trillion in 2014 to more than $2 trillion by 2019. The minister warned about the existence of more than 100 sectarian program channels, some of which incite psychological warfare and hostile propaganda, including 40 Iranian satellite channels or channels affiliated with Iran and its sectarian parties in the region. The Minister of Information Affairs concluded his speech saying that despite the destruction in some surrounding countries, the Arabian Gulf states remain the most secure, growing in all sectors, thanks to their solidarity and cohesion. He urged to conserve the accomplishments that others see as dreams and to simultaneously make the Arabian national identity the prime concern of the Arab media and to carry out the duties as partners in maintaining the Arab community's security and stability. Sheikh Hamad bin Mohammed Al Khalifa, president of the Bahrain Culture and Antiquities Authority, announced yesterday in a meeting held at the Bahrain National Museum a series of events and programs for the celebration of Muharraq being the capital of Islamic culture for 2018, in the presence of a number of business leaders and economic figures. She stressed that the most important cultural projects established during the last 10 years of infrastructure came within the project of investment in culture, which became an Arab and international model for which an international conference was set up in 2015. A number of cultural officials and believers from around the world were there to attend the special day. She pointed out that the authority will provide during the coming year a series of activities, programs that will reflect the beautiful, realistic picture of Islam, the role of arts and architecture in clarifying the bright and real side of it, and will reflect the civilizational project's enlightenment aspect in Islam. Dr. Abdulaziz Othman Al-Twajiri, Director General of Islamic Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, delivered a speech praising the historical depth of this ancient Muharraq city of great culture and heritage. He also referred to Bahrain as a special historical place and one of the origins of Arab civilization.
It's a wonderful opportunity to showcase a various variety of projects that will take place in Bahrain in 2018. 2018 is a very special year. Muharraq is the capital of Islamic culture. And here in the Bahrain Authority for Culture and Antiquities, there are so many events that we hope to achieve during that year, highlighting achievements of people of Muharraq, the architecture of Muharraq, the history of Muharraq, everything that relates to this beautiful old city.
It is the duty of the people of work, of business, of culture to hasten toward the support of this great project. So in the year 2018, we come to Muharraq and we find these projects completed. So Muharraq will be a capital of culture that radiates not only in the Islamic world, but beyond to other countries where the various cultural communities will learn about the history and the richness of Muharraq.
Love with Muharraq, and I'm doing some research. It's something about Muharraq I love and that I discovered. It's not only the atmosphere, it's simply, it's one family, one house.
With the participation of representatives from the 21 member countries of the Asian Parliamentary Assembly, the Permanent Committee on Economics and Sustainable Development is holding its meetings tomorrow in the Kingdom. Bahrain is hosting the committee thanks to its status and capability in managing parliamentarian affairs on the Asian level, following the directives of Representatives Council Speaker Ahmed Al-Mulla. To find out more on the story, we're now joined by Member of Parliament Mohammed Al-Ahmadi. Good evening, Mr. Al-Ahmadi.
Good evening.
If I can just ask you, firstly, what exactly is the agenda of the meeting?
Well, first of all, thank you for this opportunity. We are hosting the meeting of the Economic and Sustainable Development Committee of the APA, which is the Asian Parliamentary Assembly. Tomorrow will be the first day, and we have six draft resolutions to be discussed in this meeting during the next 2 days. The first resolution is talking about the Asian integrated energy market, which I think is a very important subject for all the Asian countries. And the second one is water and sanitation in Asia for all. The third resolution is environmental issues. And the fourth one is financial affairs, ensuring efforts for economic growth. The fifth resolution is about poverty eradication. And the last one is the role of the parliaments of Asia to adopt legislation in supporting the implementation of the sustainable development goals. That's the main agenda of the meeting. And this report of this meeting will be raised to the assembly in next plenary session, which will be held in Turkey.
It certainly covers a wide range of subjects. Can you tell me exactly, you know, how does this reflect Asian confidence in Bahrain hosting
well,
it here?
Yes, Bahrain has been elected as the vice president of the APA last time. That's why it is now chairing this committee, and hosting such a an event in Bahrain is really as a huge reputation for Bahrain. We have 21 countries participating in this meeting tomorrow and day after tomorrow, and they are consisting of 97 members from all around Asia's parliamentary people. I think Bahrain have gained a very good reputation in the APA itself, because the participation of the Bahraini delegation always positive. We haven't missed any meeting since the APA has established in the late 2000, and we are really enthusiastic to continue our participation in this parliament. This assembly will soon be converted to Parliament of Asia, which will be a very important subject, similar to the European Parliament, for example. This will, I think, will help the Asian nations to develop and to be equal. And we call it the Asian century. This century is called the Asian century because of all the power in Asia, like the economy and the resources.
Thank you very much for that, Mr. Alamadi, for joining us and explaining the importance of these meetings. We wish you every success. Thank you. GCC countries are celebrating the Regional Environment Day today under the theme Protection of Endangered Marine Species. The celebration contributes in enhancing cooperation amongst member states regarding the environment and planning a strategy to deal with it, especially considering the Gulf has a geographical, strategic and economic advantage. Secretary General of the Regional Organization for the Protection of the Marine Environment, Dr. Abdulrahman Al-Awadi, affirmed that the large areas of water in the world in general and in the Gulf region in particular are a major source of livelihood that can be benefited from better development in the region. He stressed the need for an enhanced cooperation to protect biodiversity at sea and to protect threatened marine species in the region.